The race is on. More than 100 experimental COVID-19 vaccines are in development from labs around the globe. Only a handful are near the finish line. Winning means saving lives. This is how it works. A successful vaccine teaches our immune system how to fight off the coronavirus. It stops it in its tracks, unable to make us sick and block from spreading to someone else. There are different ways a vaccine can do this. A traditional vaccine contains the actual virus that makes you sick, but it's either dead or a weakened version. Think flu vaccine. When a person is injected, the immune system is tricked into thinking it's being invaded by the virus. That triggers the immune system to create what are called antibodies. They destroy the fake invader. Armed with protective antibodies, the body has tools to protect itself from the real virus when a person is exposed. This is called immunity. Traditional vaccines typically take upwards of 5 years to develop. That's five more years of social distance, masks, and for some, time away from loved ones who are at risk. But the race for a vaccine has a fast-track contender. It's called the mRNA vaccine. It doesn't contain the virus at all. Instead, this vaccine targets cells in your body. Think of the mRNA vaccine as a messenger, delivering information to the brain of the cell. mRNA speaks to the proteins inside nucleic acid and teaches them how to produce antibodies on their own without ever encountering the virus, dead or alive. If the coronavirus enters the body, the cells are on the defensive and prepared to destroy the virus coming. This type of vaccine for the coronavirus was developed in record time, in a matter of months, not years. It's currently at the clinical trial stage. That's when it's tested on humans. In phase one, a small number of patients get the vaccine. Scientists check for safety, dosage, and whether it's stimulating the immune system. In phase two, hundreds more patients are added to the study. Safety and effectiveness are measured. If it's a success, thousands of patients can be included in phase three. This important phase tells researchers how many people become infected compared to those who receive the placebo. Right now, just a few of the dozens of experimental COVID-19 vaccines in the race have made it to phase three. The finish line is getting closer, but in this race, there has to be more than one winner to protect the world and save lives.